Hey guys, what we're gonna go over today is the kettlebell swing. It's one of my favorite exercises, but it's butchered so much in the land of the internet and Instagram and Facebook. So what we're gonna do is go over the three most common mistakes I see when I'm teaching a kettlebell swing to a new client. So what the kettlebell swing is supposed to look like, I'll do a couple reps. The most common thing that I see when people start is neck position. So as they come down, they have this tendency to look up. And what this does to your neck, it kind of crunches everything down, it compresses, so your ability to get almost parallel to the ground doesn't happen, because when you come down, this shortens up the spine and you kind of get stuck here. So now people start swinging too short and now they're missing all that power that they can generate. So what I tell my clients to do is thinking of sucking your neck back, almost like packing your neck back or doing a double chin, and always focusing your eyes on the ground at the bottom, and then when you get to the top, you're looking forward. So now you're a straight, solid line from neck to spine, and that's kind of the first step. The other thing I see is loose grip on the handle, and what happens is when you come up, and you lose that tension in your hands on the bell, everything else kind of falls apart, because at the top of the swing, you want to be locked out tight, almost like you're bracing for someone about to punch you in the gut. So if you really think about it, when you get to the top of the swing, it's like a front plank. Imagine if you were doing a front plank and you just kind of just like got loose and dropped, it wouldn't look really great. So the same thing happens with the swing. When you come up, and your grip is super light, everything else falls apart. Now, the other most common thing I see people do with the swing is a squat instead of a hinge. So the difference between the two is, this is a squat where the knees come forward, this is a hinge where the butt goes back and the knees are right over the ankles or a little further forward. So a lot of times people squat when they swing, when it should be a hinge and back. So if you clear up those three things, your swing is gonna look a lot better. So again, you want neck position in neutral, you want a tight grip on the handle, and you want to push those hips back into a hinge, and then drive up. And the other thing I'm going to add in extra is when you get to the top, squeeze these bad boys, squeeze as tight as possible to lock out. So when you see people swing, or you've seen my videos swinging, I'm always snapping my hips as I drive forward. So if you do that, your swing will look incredible, and I'll be proud of you if you post it online.